Today we'll take 12.9. So all of you write. Example 12.9. What about the screen today? Nobody raised any issues. Is it okay today? Right. If in figure given below, if in figure given below, R1 equal to 10 ohm, R2 equal to 40 ohm, R3 equal to 30 ohm, R4 equal to 20 ohm. R5 equal to 60 ohm. And a battery of 12 volt is connected to the arrangement calculate A the total resistance in the circuit. And B, the total current flowing through the circuit. Flowing through the circuit. Let us draw the given circuit. R1, R2, R3, R4, R5 are here. One ammeter is connected to measure the current. And plug key is also there. I have drawn it. And you write solution. Now, can you tell me how R1 and R2 are connected in the circuit? What is this type of connection? Anyone? Parallel. Very good. Aditya says R1 and R2 are connected in parallel. Can anyone tell how R3, R4 and R5 are connected? Can anyone tell me? Yes, Rahul says R3, R4, R5 are connected in parallel. That is also correct. So in this line now you write, calculation of total resistance. Calculation of total resistance. Now this is one group. R1, R2 in parallel is one group. R3, R4, R5 in parallel is another group. Now we have to calculate the effective resistance of R1 and R2 in parallel and effective resistance of R3, R4, R5 in parallel separately. So now let one by RP 1 2, that means effective resistance of parallel connected resistances 1 and 2 is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. That will be equal to, from the question you take the values of R1 and R2. R1 is 10 ohms. And R2 is 1 by 10 plus 1 by 40. 1 by 10 plus 1 by 40. This is equal to what? It is not volts, ohms. You simplify this now. You can take LCM. LCM is 40 into 4 into 1. You get 4 plus 1 by 40. That is equal to 5 by 40. Taking reciprocal, RP12 will become 40 upon 5 that is equal to 8 ohms. So effective resistance of R1 and R2 in parallel, that is RP12, is equal to 8 ohms. Have you finished? Now look at the circuit here once again. In this group, R3, R4 and R5 are connected in parallel. R3, R4 and R5 are connected in parallel. So we will call the effective resistance of these three resistors in parallel as RP 3, 4, 5 and one by RP 3, 4, 5. That means 3, 4 and 5 are connected in parallel. Equal to 1 by 30 plus 1 by 20 plus 1 by 60. Once again take LCM. LCM is 60 into 2 into 3 into 1 into 1. So you get 2 plus 3 plus 1 divided by 60 that is 6 divided by 60. This is what 1 by RP 3, 4, 5. So taking reciprocal RP 3 4 5 will be 60 by 6 and that is equal to 10 ohms. Now what we'll do is we'll redraw the circuit with these effective resistors, that is RP 1 2 and RP 3 4 5. For understanding purpose, the given circuit with effective resistances becomes like one below, like one below. This is RP 1 2 equal to 8 ohms. This is RP 3 4 5 equal to 10 ohms. So these two resistances here are replaced by one resistance by RP 1 2. Which resistances were replaced? Resistance R 1 and R 2 in parallel we have replaced by RP 1 2. So now you can see here only one resistance. Here R3, R4, R5 in parallel we have replaced by RP345. And that is equal to 10 ohms. Now, can any one of you tell me how these two resistors are connected? Are they connected end to end or both to the same points like a ladder? Okay, one says correctly. Others, like a ladder. Ladder is not correct. End to end is correct. End to end. Parallel is not correct. End to end is correct. You see here, please. 8 ohm resistor end you have connected to 10 ohm resistor end. Other end of 8 ohm resistor you have not connected directly to 10 ohm. In between there are two components. One is voltage source, other one is key. So when these are not directly connected end to end on both sides, these are not in parallel. At only one end they are connected end to end. You can see here ammeter is having zero resistance. Showing here ammeter and not showing here ammeter will not make any difference, because ammeter has got zero resistance. It is just like a wire here. So 8 ohm and 10 ohm are connected in series. Or to know whether they are connected in series or in parallel, just you mark the current. Start from battery. Show the current I. Current will flow through RP12. This current will flow through ammeter. And this current will flow through RP345. Current is not going to divide anywhere. Same current is flowing here through RP12 and RP345. If same current is flowing, then definitely RP12 and RP345 are connected in series. Okay. Then what is total resistance? Anyone? Now total resistance R is equal to RP12 plus RP345. RP345. That is 8 plus 10 equal to 18 ohms. So we have calculated now the total resistance in the circuit. Next we have to calculate the total current flowing in the circuit. The total current in the circuit equal to I V by R. The total current in the circuit I equal to V by R. That is 12 by 18. Is 2 by 3. And 2 by 3 is 0.666 dash dash ampere. Or you can write it as 0.67 amperes. 0.67 amperes. Have you all finished? Right. So now again, we'll have some important discussion on this problem. What is that is? In case of group 1, 10 ohm and 40 ohm are connected. 10 ohm and 40 ohm are connected in a parallel. And what was its effective resistance? 8 ohm. The effective resistance is 8 ohm. Compare this 8 ohm with 10 ohm and 40 ohm. You find that this 8 ohm is less than smaller resistance connected in parallel. Make this observation, very important observation. Next, in second group, thirty, 20 and 60 ohm resistors connected in parallel. What is the effective resistance? 10 ohm. This 10 ohm is also smaller than the smallest of parallel connected resistors. Smaller than the smallest of the resistors connected in parallel. So this point we'll note now. Note 1. When resistors are connected, in parallel, are connected in parallel. The effective resistance will be always lesser than smaller resistance, lesser than smaller resistance. Second point, when resistors are connected, in series, and put comma here and here after parallel and after series you put one comma. When resistors are connected in series, The effective resistance will be always, you look at this combination, 8 and 10 connected in parallel. 18 ohm is the total resistance. This 18 is more than bigger resistance or larger resistance or higher resistance. Is it right? Will be always okay. More than will be always more than the larger resistance. The larger resistance. So these points are very, very important. What else we have observed in series circuit and in parallel circuit? Three. In parallel circuits, voltage across all the resistors remains the same, and current differs. And current differs. It should be in series circuits. In series circuits, voltage across each resistor differs, and the current remains same, and the current remains same. Now I will show you different electric appliances that we use at our home. Now look at this electrical appliance. This is actually massage machine. When you have cramps in muscles, you can use this machine. You see what is written here? Can anyone tell me what is written here? To 250 volts. Is it written? 200 to 250 volts. Right, very good. And this is also another massage machine, small one. Reading here is a little bit difficult for you, But you can Can you see the number here? Can anyone tell me how much is this? 110 to 240. It is 110 to 240. Okay. Very good. Now look at this. This is mobile charger. What is this? This is mobile charger. How much is here? Hundred to 240. See, almost all home appliances that we use in our home operate at 240 volts. How much voltage is required for our home appliances? How much potential difference is required for the home appliances? 240 volts. Even lamps, your television, supply to your laptop, mixer, refrigerator, everything needs 240 volt. Now you tell me, if you have to operate fan and refrigerator, how you will connect them in circuit? That is, whether you will connect them in series or in parallel. Anyone can tell me? If all have to get same voltage, how they must be connected? Parallel. Very good. One, for any home appliance to work properly, 240 volt is required. So to supply them 240 volts, we need to connect the home appliances in parallel. If you connect them in series, different home appliance will get different voltage and their operation will not be according to your expectation. Their working will not be according to your expectation. So to make them to work according to your expectation, you have to connect all the home appliances in parallel. This point and this point are very, very important. Are very, very important.